The Los Angeles Wheelmen Bike Club has been hosting the Grand Tour Double Century since 1959. It starts in Port Hueneme, and in its current form it goes to Ojai and Montecito before returning to Port Hueneme. It doesn't have a heck of a lot of climbing, so it's ideal for an old duffer like me. But there was a slight problem. The temperature was predicted to be in the low 90s at lunch. The ride starts at 4 a.m, which would get me to lunch at 1 p.m, so I decided to start at 2 a.m. instead.
And that's my head unit making happy sounds. It's cold, but not as cold as I thought it was going to be. That means it's definitely going to be warm, like I thought it would be. I'll catch you guys later. So I'm currently riding about 24 miles an hour in the dark. I got a nice wide shoulder, but it's a farm road. There's a fair bit of debris, so I have to be alert. This is pretty spicy. Anyway, 5 miles in, almost done, right? You remember the bad old days of cue sheets? Constantly getting lost, constantly having to stop because you can't read them on rough roads. Yeah, I'll take a head unit any day. These are amazing. You youngins, you've never had to use a cue sheet. You don't know how lucky you are. Turned onto Pleasant Valley, first turn, really. It's 49 degrees and it's 1:30 in the morning, 1:40. So when the sun comes up just before dawn, it's going to get really cold, like low 40s. Brrr, that's going to be cold. Mile loop.
So I finished the first 40 mile loop in 2 hours. I grabbed a sandwich I'd stashed in my hotel room and set out on the second loop a little bit before the ride officially started. Here I am arriving at the second control. Of course they're not open, I'm far too early, but at least there was a restroom there.
All right, we're gonna just crank it up, or not yet, right?
Not yet.
We're not quite cranking it up.
We're still going mellow.
They can't believe that I just wouldn't leave, so I bid adieu to my friends. She's from the islands, her body's been kissed by the sun. And the coconut replaces the smell of the bar, and I don't know if it's her or the rum. I got my toes in the water, hands in the sand, not a worry in the world, a cold beer in my hand. Life is good today. Life is good today.
So I'd made such good time over the first 100 miles, I actually had to consciously slow down on the Ojai bike path so I wouldn't get to lunch before 9 o'clock when they were supposed to open. But when I did get to lunch at Sarasota Park, they were just unloading the truck. I figured I'd get food faster if I helped them. Plus, I'd know where the food was. I helped out for an hour. And then I grabbed some sugary cookies, some potato chips, a couple of cans of soda, and filled up my water bottles and headed on out. It was only about 70 degrees Fahrenheit, so I'd achieved what I'd set out to do, which was to get to lunch without suffering from heat stroke.
Ain't that America? Something to see, babe. Ain't that America? All my free, yeah.
I got to the food stop at Rincon Point just as they were setting up. I grabbed a few things, but when I counted up the calories in my head, I realized it was only about 200 calories, and I'd done something fairly similar back at the lunch stop. And even though I'd stopped at a gas station earlier to get some sandwiches, if I'd stopped and done the math, I would have known that I was severely in calorie debt. And this error caused me some problems just a few miles up the road. A few miles past the Rincon rest stop, I realized I was bonking hard, and I needed to do something about it. This is not something you can just ride through. So I stopped and ate half a Probar. I really didn't want to eat any of it, but I knew I had to. I also drank some diluted Mountain Dew from one of my water bottles. The trick there is that the sugar in the soda will kick in quickly and give you energy, but the starch in the Probar will release energy more slowly and prevent a sugar crash. The plan is to get some calories in me and soft pedal until I can get back to the Rincon Point rest stop, where I will eat everything in sight. Hopefully they'll be set up when I get back there. It's amazing how you can go from collapsed in a ditch to playing like a puppy in less than 30 minutes. I stopped here for 15 minutes. I filled up my water bottles. I had another can of Mountain Dew, and I had a cup of noodles. Now, cup of noodles is not generally part of a healthy diet. There's way too much salt. But when you're endurance cycling, it ticks all the boxes. There's plenty of carbs, there's a lot of salt, which you need, and there's some water too. Well, I'm fully recovered and it's time to go home, 30 miles, flat, with a tailwind. Thank you.
Mm-hmm.